So, this is the kitchen project. This is now completed. As you can see, this doorway was modified. It used to be about half the width. So we increased it by half, about 30 inches. As you can see, it's really open. You can see well into the kitchen. It really opens the room up. When you walk into the kitchen, we're first going to go to the left. In the other pictures, there used to be a small hutch. Now we have this beautiful cabinetry. We still have to fill the top up with the crystal. We haven't gotten to that. But a centerpiece in there, so we can do that. Huge cabinets here, and then a way to organize all our belongings down here, which is really nice. All with piston clothes. So for instance, here's an example. We used to have all this stuff here, all the kid stuff, all sit on the floor, and now it's nicely put in a drawer. All the pencils and everything kind of organized. Pretty slick. And then all of our keys and everything used to be sitting out in the open, but now they're all put away, and we have a mail slot, and all that mess is now kind of somewhere where we don't have to look at it every day if you don't want to. So this is really nice as far as what we wanted to get done. So let's move on. Laura bought some nice wall art. We're still working on the other side of the wall. We got this, all these are all the new cabinets. This is the layout of the room. I'll get a little closer, zoomed in here in a little bit. It's really pretty. The countertop is Santa Cecilia. Real pretty stuff. Let's go around the room with the cabinets real quick. This is a garbage can pullout, which was before a garbage can sitting on the side of our countertop. So this is nicely tucked away now. Before, this was in pretty much an unusable area because it was so deep. But now, this is one big Lazy Susan that rolls around really nicely, so that we can keep everything kind of organized and get to it without having to take everything out of the drawer in order to get to it. This was the next option that we added. This was not like this before that. This was a straight cabinet going to the wall. So this is pretty cool. It's called the garage. Comes up, hide the toaster oven, your bread, and everything else back there. And then you close it. It's all piston closed, so you don't have to worry about any slamming. This is the other stuff we did. This is another the corner unit. Some of these cabinets aren't filled up yet because we got more space now. So this area pretty much stayed the same. Same type of cabinets, except we went to a 36-inch cabinet instead of a 30-inch cabinet with the crown molding on top. I think it really came out nicely across the top. The same microwave we had in there before. This is a new oven, pretty slick. It even has options for pizza and stuff like that. It has convection and all kinds of cool stuff. It's got the grill going across all the burners, so it's really nice when you have like a pan. Instead of having to move it over or something like that, you can just slide it right in the middle if you want it to cool off. It's pretty. I've actually used it quite a bit, and it's nice. What else? So we're moving over here. This is the same. Oh, let me give you an idea. This is one of the options we did. So we did a mosaic backsplash with the tile backsplash, mosaic slash tile backsplash with the trim in the middle. It came out real nice. Really, really nice. And then if you come over here, we did a black granite sink. And just because Laura doesn't like to have dirty hands be touching knobs, we went with a touch faucet where you just touch it on, touch it off. So you have this unit here, it comes out, it's got sprayer on there and all that stuff. It's pretty neat. It is battery operated, so like if you can see the blue light, that blue light doesn't go on, your battery's dead basically. Time to swap out the batteries, it takes a C battery. Hold on, Nate, hold on. If I come over here, this was another big part of it. These cabinets, before, was this about a 12-inch pantry deep. These are now a 24-inch deep pantry. If I open this up, huge shelves come rolling out for all your canned goods and everything like that. Very organized. As you can see, we have several of them. And then this one, which I'll be installing puck lights into, is more this the main stock area. You stock all your belongings in there, and you don't have to, things you're not going to get to as much. There's one on top for all your pots and pans, things like that. And then this one's for our liquor cabinet and all. These are all 24 inch deep, so they're really nice. You can see how they kind of lay up against the door. There's not too much room in there anymore. It used to be about a 10 inch gap between the door jamb and the start of the pantry. So it's kind of cool. And then this beast, this is another thing Laura wouldn't compromise on or anything like that. She wanted only the finest. And it is pretty slick. Samsung is a beast. Open this bad boy up. 29 square feet of huge amounts of space. Lots of good stuff in here. You know, it's got like this slide out stuff. Like these things slide in and slide out so you can have more room. And then if you close that up, you got this middle drawer, which is kind of like supposed to be like the kids drawer kind of thing. Things they can get at easily, cheeses and fruits and stuff like that. And then you got a base drawer, which is your freezer bottom drawer with two shelves that come out. You know, one for like your vegetables and stuff, and then the other one is for your fruits and stuff. Pretty slick. And coming back over here, you can see how big that entryway is. So it really opened up the room. So you can, when you're having a party or something like that, you can really see everything what's going on. Also, what we did too, this floor, new and different, I guess you might say. We went with a brick pattern, 12 inch. Really tight lines. That's one thing I like about it. The lines are just like uber tight. They're not even an eighth inch. They're less than that. I mean, I'm sitting right on the tile and it still looks thin. Let's see what else. We still got the blinds on order. They haven't come in yet. And then I guess the only other kind of neat thing, I guess, is the pantry. I kind of remodeled this a little bit. Put the old cabinets in here. These are the old cabinets. Restructured this so it's a little better design. Took one of the old cabinets and the old countertops, put it in here so we have a folding area. Worked out pretty well. The washing machines are now stacked. And then we also have it over here for more storage space for like hats and gloves and stuff. But that's about it. That's my, that's our new kitchen. And it's brick pattern going through the whole, we tiled everything. Everything got tiled. So the bathroom got tiled. It got all redone. I think it turned out really well. Got it all done in about 3 weeks. A lot of painting. Just a lot of painting. What else is cool? Everything else is pretty standard. Oh, this is cool. We used to not have any light over here, so it was really tough to see. So we got two can lights in here. This was a trick to put in, but we got to put in. The guy did an excellent job as far as just how he did the molding and all. Very professional. He was very good. At work every day at 7 o'clock in the morning, you could trust that he was going to be there, that he was going to get the job done. And he did it to his best ability. He just did an awesome job. And that's really about it. That's about all my whole kitchen.